Oh, sorry. Didn't see you there. I've been trying to get the mud that was caked into my skull back in 2019 at Bob's Big Timber Backyard Ultra out of my skull. I just can't get it out. It's been 3 years, maybe one day. But this race, albeit initially known for the Mudfest, has recently turned into one of the most premier Backyard Ultra events in the entire country. And there's a couple reasons for that. First off, it takes place on a seventh generation tree farm, and it's seen some of the biggest names in the Backyard Ultra scene battle it out on their course. But this year, the big names, there are none. There are absolutely no big names, but there are 65 entrants in this race, and they're all super motivated to take home the top spot. And that's why I believe that this year will be the most special year in Bob's Big Timber Backyard Ultra history. It'll be a year for the record books. I'm excited. Let's dive into my top five predictions. Let's dive right into these predictions. Fifth place, I've got it going to Ron Wireman, and he's an absolute speedster on paper. Earlier this June, he won the Damn Yeti 50K running 3:31. Just this past year, he ran the Three Sisters Ultra Festival 12-hour run and made it 68 miles. 2 years ago, in 2019, he ran 129 miles at a 24-hour event, kind of similar to the Backyard Ultra, but obviously you can pick your own pace at a 24-hour event. You can't pick your own pace at a Backyard Ultra because you have to slow down for the clock. He's a total fast guy on paper. He's making his debut in the Backyard Ultra scene. Will it translate? I think sort of, but I've got him finishing fifth. Ron Wireman, fifth place. Fourth place, I've got it going to Michelle Barton. This is her first ultra since 2019. She may be coming into this race more rested and more motivated than anyone else in this entire field, and that's why I've got her finishing fourth. She took second place at the Heartland 50, running 8:51 back in 2019. She's done two 10-hour events in her career. You know, her first ultra, you know, I always like to look, what experience do people have? Her first ultra was back in 2012. She's been around the block. She's been there, done that with a bunch of different events. She's gonna absolutely shock the world in her debut Backyard Ultra race, and I'm super excited to see it. Michelle Barton, I've got you finishing fourth place. Third place, I've got it going to a phenomenal runner from Virginia, and that's Erin Williams. She's absolutely gonna go for this race. Ridge Runner Nation may know her well because she finished second place at the Tuscarora 100 just this past year in 2020. She finished sixth place at the Mount Damascus 50 miler in 2019. She also has a couple other wins under her belt, you know, if you check that out. She won the Eagle Up 100 in 2019, running 18:04. Crazy fast there. She's done some of the toughest ultras on the East Coast. You know, she's not afraid to kind of get in the fast stuff, but she's also not afraid to get in some of the hardest mountain stuff on the East Coast. I think she's gonna be super prepared for this race. Erin Williams, I've got you finishing third place. A Backyard Ultra cannot go far without this person, and that's the assist. I've got it going to Shan Riggs, and he's an incredibly fast guy. He ran 15:33 at the Jackpot Ultra 100 in 2020. He won the Indiana Trail 100 back in 2014. His first ultra was 2006. You couldn't even get an iPhone in 2006. And the dude's only getting faster too. That's the one thing that kind of impresses me. I don't know what it is in the water for people that train and run Bob's Big Timber Backyard Ultra, but I feel like everyone that runs this race is just on the upward slope of their ultra running trajectory. Everyone that runs this race gets faster with age, and it's incredible to see. Shan Riggs, I've got you putting up an incredible performance and taking home the assist at Bob's Big Timber this year. In taking home the win at Bob's Big Timber Backyard Ultra this year, I've got it going to Tom Flummerfelt from Massachusetts most recently. He was the assist at the Keystone Backyard Ultra. And I'm not gonna lie to you guys, I was not a big Keystone drinker in college. I was more of a natty light guy personally. But you know, Tom decided to go to the Keystone Backyard Ultra. I really hope he's a sponsor. And you know, he put up 36 yards, which is incredible. And you know, he was the assist there. He has some incredible finishes as well on his resume. You know, a couple years ago, he finished sixth place at the Bigfoot 200 in 2018. You know, he in 2017, you know, I like to look back a couple years. 2017, you know, 2018 Bigfoot, 2017, what'd you do for me? Well, you know, he ran the Cruel Jewel 100 and then ran TDG. That's pretty solid. You know, a 300K race. You know, people just do those for fun, right? That's just a weekend for some people. But I mean, for Tom, you know, he went out there, absolutely crushed it. You know, some other races that he's done. Maybe you've heard of them. Tahoe 200. Okay, I've heard that one's all right. What about the Vermont 100 East Coast race? Oh, there we go. People know that race. I mean, these are some of the toughest ultras in the world that he's not only ran in, but he's competed in and placed extremely well. I mean, he will be absolutely locked in. This is a 100% Wesley certified guarantee prediction that Tom Flummerfelt is going to take home the win at Bob's Big Timber Backyard Ultra this weekend. I can't wait to see it. And before we get out of here, I do have some breaking news. Tanner Lee is officially out of Bob's Big Timber Backyard Ultra this weekend. You know, Tanner's got a bunch of other backyard ultras he's currently signed up for, and we're super excited to see him go out and crush those races in the near future. Thanks for watching another prediction video. You guys know the drill. In the comment section below, let me know who your top picks are for Bob's Big Timber Backyard Ultra this year. You know, if you enjoyed this video, hit the like button, subscribe to us on YouTube if you haven't already. This weekend is gonna be an incredible weekend at the Tree Farm. I know there's a ton of people in Regener Nation that are super excited. It's gonna be an incredible event, and I cannot wait to follow along and see the madness unfold. We'll see you guys on the next one.